Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of creatnprocess. In today's video, we're going to explore some amazing AI photo editing tools from Fotor. If you want to enhance, restore, or transform your images effortlessly, these tools will be a game changer. Whether you are a designer, photographer, or just love experimenting with AI, these features will save your time and deliver stunning results. In the first part of this video, we have covered some powerful AI tools like Photo Enhancer, Skin Retouch, Object Remover, Background Remover, and more. If you haven't seen it yet, check the link in the description or at top corner of the video. So let's get started. Fotor has a lot of great AI tools that make photo editing simple and quick. And here's what we'll cover in this tutorial. First, we'll cover AI Upscale. Then we'll talk about Old Photo Restorer. Then Watermark Remover. Then we'll talk about Face Swap, Open Eyes, AI Filters, AI Image Generator, and lastly, Batch Editor. So let's go through each tools and see how they work. First, we'll talk about AI Upscaler. This tool is perfect if you want to increase the resolution of your image without losing the quality. It sharpens the detail and enhances the texture, making your photo look crisp and high definition. For example, I have this low resolution image. As you can see, the image is a little blurry, so to upscale it, select the image and click on AI Upscaler. And it will take some time. And here we go. Our image has been upscaled. Here you can see the difference. This is original one and this is the image after upscaling. You can see the resolution has improved. The edges are sharper and the details are more refined. This is ideal for printing or professional use. Once you're happy, you can just click on apply and there we go. Our image has been upscaled. For example, here's our second image. You can see the flowers are a little blurry, base and everything. So to upscale this, what I'll do is I'll again select this and click on AI Upscale and just wait a little bit. And there we go. Let's zoom it in and see the difference. So this is our original image and this is the image after upscaling. So you can see the petals are so detailed and you can see even the glasses also. If I just compare it, you can see the difference. Once you're done it, click apply and there we go. We have upscaled the image. Next, we have Old Photo Restorer. This tool is great for bringing old, faded and damaged photos back to life. If you have an old black and white photos with scratches and noise, it's very easy. You just have to select your image or open your image. And over here, if you go down, you can see Old Photo Restorer. Just click on it and okay. And here you got two options. Photo Restorer, Photo Colorizer. So you have to check both. First, Photo Restorer will restore all the scratches and noises. And after that, Photo Colorizer will apply color to the photo. So check them both and click on Start. The AI will remove the cracks, noise and discolorization while also adding colors, making the image look fresh and new. And there we go. You can see the difference. This is the old photo with scratches and this is after fixing it. You can see all the scratches, this line and all, it has been fixed and after that it has given that nice color. Let's look at another photo. Here you can see it's a black and white. Let's say you want to just apply the color. So what I'll do is I'll just go in, okay, and you can just switch off this one, Photo Restorer, and if you just check this and apply it, it will apply only the colors. Let's see. And there we go. Our photo has been colorized. We just applied the color. So let's see the image. This is our original black and white and here is the colored version. Isn't it great? It looks amazing. So it's very easy to colorize your image with this option. So just Old Photo Restorer and it will do everything. Now let's talk about the Watermark Remover. If you have an image with a watermark or unwanted text, this tool can help. So here we got an image with a watermark and it is very easy to remove using the Watermark Remover tool. So here, if you go down, you can see this Watermark Remover. Just click on it. And after that, you got two options. We got Auto and Brush. Brush is for manual and Auto it will automatically detect. So here you got two options. First one is advanced and second is standard. So right now we got advanced, so I think it's better to choose advanced, where you can remove watermark, text and logos here. And with a brush you can manually like select the region. For example, let's say you got a brush, you can just manually select the region. And I think for this image I want it to be overall, so I'll just select auto and click on remove, and it will automatically detect all these watermark text and remove it. And here it is, our image is here and all the watermark has been gone. If you compare it, you can see this is the watermark and this is the image after removing the watermark. Let's say you want to use the brush. Here we got under image, you want to remove this, so I want to use the watermark tool again. Okay, watermark remover, and here let's choose the brush and let's adjust the brush size. Okay, and let's paint over it, click on remove, and let's see the changes. And there we go, the watermark disappear seamlessly without leaving any marks. This is great for cleaning up images while maintaining their natural look. Next is the face swap tool. This AI tool allows you to swap faces in photos easily. Under photo on the front page you can see this face swap option, just click on it and this will open this window. Here you can swap in two ways, you can swap single faces or you can swap multiple number of faces. So to swap the single faces, upload an image with a face you want to replace, then upload another image with a face you want to swap in. Or I'm going to go over here and choose the image from here, so let's see. Okay, and let's say I'll select this image and click on swap, and it will automatically swap it within a minute. And there it is, that's how you can swap single images. The new face is blended perfectly into the image while maintaining natural expression and lighting. This is how you can swap single images. Let's see how to swap multiple number of faces. So here it is. So first of all, you have to import your target image. So you can just go into your computer and upload it, or I'll go from here. Here I got two images. I'll choose this one. Here we got two faces. These faces can be targeted individually. So I want to swap this face with another male guy. So let's choose a face. Select this one. And for the lady, let's choose another one. So let's choose this one and I'll apply it. We'll click on swap and it will start the process and we'll wait for it. And there it is. This is the original image and this is where the face has been swapped. And there it is. You can just click over here and download your image. This is useful for fun edits, professional mockups, or even fixing group images. Next, let's look at AI Open Eyes. This AI tool is perfect if you have a great photo but the subject eyes are closed. Instead of retaking the photos, you can use AI to open them naturally. Select the image under AI photo editor tool. You go to beautify and under beautify, you can see over here open eyes. Just click on it and it will automatically scan the photo, detect the closed eyes and seamlessly opens them while maintaining a realistic and natural look. So we got three options over here, standard, medium and max. You can use it according to the requirement of your image. And there we go, you can see the difference. This is our closed eye and this is the fixed one. So I think the standard looks cool, and after that just click on apply and your image has been fixed. In the same way, let's say you have another image something like this, while taking picture your eyes are closed. So it's very easy. Again, just go to beautify and click on open eye, and with the standard setting it will apply the effect and it will automatically open the eye of the character, our original image, and after editing. This is great for portraits, get it moments where someone blink at the wrong time. You can just fix it with one click. Next we have AI filters. This tool applies various artistic filters to your images, transforming them into different styles like cartoon, sketches, avatar, and some more popular filters like Ghibli style, minifigure, caricature and more. Let's say you want to apply the Ghibli style, just press on it and it will apply that filter to your image. And there we go, here's the Ghibli style image. This is our original image and it has converted it into this, very easy with just one click. So you can convert any image just like this. Let's check out another image. So I got this image Okay, let's try different effects. So let's go to again AI filter, and here we got this collection. I'll choose the cyberpunk. So let's apply that. This AI filter has generated this image. This is our original and this is the cyberpunk look, and I think it looks cool. So we have just used two of the filters. There are lots of filters over here and each of them are amazing. Here you got a clay portrait, there's a comic look, a sketch, and lots more, so you can try out. Now let's look at AI image generator. This tool creates stunning AI generated artworks based on text prompts. So as you can see, I have generated a lot of images before this using the prompt. So let's create something. So we got a prompt here. Let me paste it here. So I'm going to create a futuristic city at sunset, and here we got some looks. So we got a photography, we got a photorealistic, we can get a filmy look, pinin, we got that Ghibli star, and children's illustration. So I think for this futuristic city look, I would choose this film look, and let's generate. And there we go. You can see the city looks so real. Let me try another option, let's say photorealistic, and let's generate the image. So let's see the image. Yes, you can see the city. So these are the two images it has generated using that prompt, and it can create amazing scenes. It also create amazing characters. As you can see, I have generated some of these characters I have generated using these prompts, and it's so super realistic. It's, you can't tell the difference whether it's a photo or AI generated. It's so real. So it has got that amazing feature. So let me try one more prompt. Panda astronaut. You can generate 2 to 3 images over here. I'll select 2. Okay, and after that I'll choose this photorealistic photography one and generate, and let's see what it creates. And there we go, let's see the images. Okay, and here this one is also, both of the images are so cool, so realistic. So with a proper prompt you can generate so realistic images very easily with AI image generator. Finally, we have the batch editor, perfect for editing multiple number of images. You can remove background, resize the image, crop, convert, or compress photos in just few clicks. So let's select some images. So this. Okay, and I'm importing it. Okay, these are the images. Now you want to resize it, just click on the resize. Here you got these settings, we got by pixel or by scale. So with the pixel you can choose these sizes, 2k, 1k, all of that, or you can even customize it. Here you can adjust the size. As you can see, it is affecting to all the images, right? In the same way you can scale the size 50%, 20%, or you can customize it here with the slider, like 100% to 1%. And here you can adjust the height, that's the same thing, and you can click on apply and it will apply to all the images. In the same way we can crop the images. Let's cancel this. Okay, and now let's go to crop. So let's say you want to crop it. So here you can crop it in different sizes. You can go down and see all these sizes, iPhone size, YouTube thumbnail size, and all these 3x2 sizes. Okay, and you can do it in landscape or portrait, so it's depend on your requirement. And here you can align it, you can keep it down on the top, sideways, or at the middle. So these are the things. Once you're happy with that, you can just click on apply and it will be cropped to all the images. Cancel this.
To convert the images
now, let's say you want to
PNG
convert
or web these images
into something else.
Go to convert images.
Go to convert
and select the format
and the quality and click apply. Lastly, use the compress option to reduce the file size while maintaining quality. In the same way, we got the last option, that is background remover. If you just click on it, it will remove the background from all the images. These tools are perfect for anyone looking to enhance, restore, or transform their photos quickly and easily. And that's it for some of the best AI tools for footers. Whether you are upscaling images, restoring old photos, or applying creative filters, these features make editing faster and more efficient while maintaining high quality. If you want to try out yourself, I'll leave the link of the website in the description below. Also, let me know in the comment section which AI tool you found most useful. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.